She's
you
laughing.
Had white shirts and shorts on.
Yeah.
I had white pants
they
on.
They made me look so funky in the middle section.
Well, those jeans that came up to people's midriffs.
I wore the midriff white jeans. I mean, it just was a... I don't know why I thought that was a good idea. I think because Anne Roth talked me into thinking it was a good idea. She can talk me into anything.
Well, in the context of the movie, it made perfect sense.
It did. It did.
But it's a little scary for the kids at home.
Terrifying. I had no idea. I thought I looked fantastic, but I was drunk, so what do you know?
You guys have been mother and daughter for 8 weeks? 6 weeks?
Was it 6 weeks? Yeah.
I thought maybe 3 weeks, yeah. I think.
I think only 3 weeks, yeah. And we didn't really get a lot of on-screen time together.
A couple of times,
but I would have liked to have had more with this one, because we had fun off-camera. We could do another story. We could do way, way, way back.
The prequel.
With the prequel.
So do you spend any time on a picture like this, like preparing to be mommy and dad, mommy and daughter, or is that just like...
We don't really get a lot of time. We didn't get a lot of rehearsal time, but we just, I think as actors, you're used to just jumping in
and
immediately. Yeah, and we certainly had a lot of time to do that, and one of the we all got put in the actor house, we call it. It was a huge big white
beach house.
Literally, we filmed this on the beach. I walked to work every day down the beach, and we hung out in this big house together when we weren't filming, which is when you're making a movie, a lot of your time is spent in your trailer, but there were no trailers. We were in this big house together, so we got to spend a lot of time.
Yeah, we'd play cards. Did we play cards? We'd watch YouTube videos.
We watched a lot of YouTube videos. We did play some card games and learned some
Uno was out
tricks.
For a while.
Uno and River doing song and little dance routines for us. And
he plays
River
the
Alexander, who plays our
the
her
kid.
Son.
Yeah.
My son, aka husband. It's a, we had a married old married couple relationship, so I call him my hubby.
Alternate hubby.
Yes.
So did you play a lot of Uno before this movie, or is that something that...
I think we did it in Spanish class when I was younger, but no. But we did, I mean, I felt like as a cast, we really bonded being able to stay in a house together, and then I would always come on set to watch Allison's scenes if I was there, just because I had so much fun watching her. And so it was just, I remember one night in particular, Liam and I had a scene together, and then afterwards, I think it was you, Tony, and Steve all had a scene together, and you were upstairs having a good time. And so in between, I would run up the stairs just to like listen to their stories.
Well, it was one particular scene in which the scene description was the adults stumble into the dunes. So that was all we were doing. We were waiting around to stumble into the dunes. So Steve and Tony and I were being quite silly up in one of the holding rooms.
It was a lot of fun.
It was one of my favorite nights filming of you guys running up and getting around. And
Liam and I went up. I was like, what's all that laughing? What's that laughter? And I came up, and then I went back down. I was like, Liam, you have to come. And so we would sit on the bed until they'd be like, we're ready for you.
We had a blast.
Absorb.
So is it like checking in on your parents? Is that... what it feels like, or they feel like...
No, much more fun.
Yeah.
It's more like checking in on your like aunts and uncles.
Yeah, exactly. It was much more of
with
that sort
like
of...
like no responsibility for
we
you.
We didn't care what kind of a bad example we were setting or how unprofessional I was, too. But we knew how to have fun. And
but
I was doing research.
Well, is there anything unprofessional? I mean, isn't that kind of like what you're there for in a way?
Yes, you are supposed to play and be silly, and but we were being a little bad. But you know, Betty, I always saying was just to research my character, because Betty did...
It was bonding. We were doing...
Yeah.
We were becoming method.
So is the idea of being thrown into a house with a bunch of actors, you know some of them, but not all of them terribly well, is that actually scary?
It is a little bit in the beginning. You don't know. You're sort of cautious of not overstepping boundaries or giving them in their space. And then
shared a bathroom.
Yeah, we shared bathroom.
That was weird.
You know, you got to think of, there's a lot of things you got to think about.
It can be like a series unto itself, like the real world actors.
Exactly. Actually, would have been a really good entertaining show with us. It really would have been.
So when you got the script for this, did you just go... bam, that's it. I know how to do this. I've got it. Or
I didn't know. Like, oh, I know how to do this. I read it and I went, oh, this is so great. I want to meet with them and I want to do this.
Your character is more layered than I guess you would normally get scripts for a girl of your age and people.
It's really, it's a layered character, but I feel like all the characters are layered. I mean, what's beautiful about the script is that, and I saw it for the first time last night, that when you're watching it, you could understand the dynamics between the characters and the relationships with very few words. There's all of a sudden you understand the history and the summer's mm-hmm. past through the performances, but also it's very tight. It's not like, by the way, this whole thing happened. You're not telling the audience anything, it's just showing it. And I really love that about Susanna's character, is that even though, like, my monologues are about crabs, and, you know, that's the majority of my my speaking in the film, we get to understand her and that she's looking for a friend and that she's very disconnected from her mother and she's reaching out to Duncan. And, you know, I think this is her first sort of, there's a transition just with her and Steph, you know, she was with the popular girls before. It was kind of a path she was on. She's like, that's not who I am. She's figuring herself out too. And the script says all that in very few words.
Yeah. Everybody's trying to just connect. Everybody wants to be connected to or with somebody, mm-hmm. and that's what the poignant parts of this film are about, and all the characters just wanting to be loved and be, you know, love and be loved and be seen. And Betty, my character, is just pathetically desperate.
But she does get to steal the show quite often.
She does. Oh my God, she was exhausting. I was talking before that after every take I would just go like this, and I wouldn't come talk to anyone in between, because mm-hmm. she was probably the most exhausting character I've ever played in my life. It was exhausting. Betty is exhausting, and I think that because of Tony's character, she has they find a connection there, because their husbands have both left them, and they find their way to each other. And I think Betty lets some air in towards at the end of the movie. You see her connect with Tony's character, that they both see each other for what they've lost, and they're not alone, and things are going to get better, and there's hope at the end of it. But exhausting.
Is that more interesting to you when you read a script like this than the part where you know you're going to kind of walk into the scene and just kill and do a big comic beat that people are going to go crazy about?
Oh, do I think of it that way?
Well, I mean, are you interested? Are you looking to the third act and looking at, you know, your character's quieter moments and more introspective moments that are there and going, okay, that's where I'm heading. That's kind of
yeah. Oh yeah, I look at the whole thing. I never think of, oh, this is going to kill the people. I think of, I usually think, think about what she needs, and Betty needs to. She needs to have fun, and she wants everyone to be in her. You know, she wants everyone to accept her and love her, and not see the. She needs a lot of attention. She's very needy. So,
she seems to be convincing herself as well.
Yes. Yeah. She wants this to be the best summer ever, and it's going to be. It's going to be fantastic. We're going to have a lot of fun. It's going to be fantastic. I couldn't be happier. Yes, my husband's gay, he left me, but so what? I mean, you know, it's like she won't stop. She's like, she was a crazy ride. She was a.
It's a lot of fun to watch.
So this is not the real Allison Janney we're watching on screen
here. No, no, no. I
it's
could
not
be more opposite from Betty in a lot of ways, because I like to lounge and cat-like poses.
I was just thinking cat-like, actually.
I'm like a kitty cat. I just like to lie around and I'm lazy. So Betty had to churn up those fires, and, you know.
Has it always been that way? Because you've played a lot of big characters over the career.
Yeah, I'm pretty tired and lazy.
But I mean, do they come to you? They now come to you. There are some people who are looking for an Allison Janney type, maybe even Allison Janney.
I usually don't get those parts. I actually auditioned for an Allison Janney where they said they want someone like Allison Janney, and I auditioned and I didn't get the part. That actually happened to me. I've had that happen in real life, and for voiceovers too. They want, could you sound more like Allison Janney? I'm like, I am Allison Janney. I don't know how I can sound any more like Allison Janney.
By the way, Kaiser Permanente. I love Kaiser. Every time it comes on, I get a big smile.
Thrive.
I'm guessing you get a big smile too, because there's a
I never hear it. I never listen to the radio.
I listen to NPR.
You do?
Yeah.
See, you're smarter than I am. I don't even.
It's just to hear your voice.
So was there any downside in all of this in the show? I mean, it seems like a pretty happy group together. It seems like, but it was just a short. It's a fairly short schedule.
Very short schedule.
It was my first film by myself. I was 18.
So really?
It was my first one. I know. No one knew that. But
I didn't know that.
Yeah. Well, I felt like everyone kind of took care of me. So. It was like a big...
You didn't see. I mean, I would never have known that.
Well, I've been on sets for a long time, but yeah. I realized, I was like, oh my gosh, I'm a little lonely. So I spent most of my time in the house, like being with everybody, because I had nothing else to do. I was staying in a
hotel
room.
You didn't have to go to school. You didn't have to do the school stuff.
No, I was on summer. I had just graduated, and I went from graduation, had a couple weeks, and then... flew there, and I was like, I would rather be on set with everyone. Yeah. So I'd hang out in the living room, and Rob Corddry would be out there just hanging out.
Rob Corddry. he was our entertainment. Rob Corddry.
Oh my gosh.
Not cat-like.
Not cat-like. No, clown-like.
He's hysterical. He is a total clown, a total fool, and he made us laugh quite a bit.
So you saw the film at Sundance?
I saw the film at Sundance. She just saw it last night.
I saw it last night,
So how was that Sundance experience for you?
That was wild, because it was the first time, it was our first screening. We had no idea how people were going to, and I saw it before, because I don't like to see myself on screen with a lot of other people there for the first time. It's kind of shocking for me, so I like to. So I saw it on a little TV, like hours before the real screening, and I loved the movie, but it would have been fun to see it with and hear the audience reaction, because after when they came out, everyone was just flipped over it and loved it so much. It was thrilling. It was like being the pretty girl at the party. You know, we were like, oh my God, we are pretty. Everybody wants to dance. It was really exciting to be there and be watch that all happen and go out and really celebrate together, and especially the sale that was just monumental. It was kind of exciting.
It'd be awesome.
Millions and millions and millions of doll hairs.
So have you seen it with an audience since? Did you see it with an audience last night?
No, I saw it I was like, I'm doing press tomorrow, and I haven't seen the movie. Can I please see it? Like, please?
We need to sneak it. We need to see it with the real audience to hear the...
Yeah.
To make sure you're still in.
I was in New York, so I couldn't go to the screening, and I was so bummed. And then I got emails the next day, and I was like, everybody loves it, and it's being sold, da 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 da. But I was so excited. Yeah. It's so wonderful when you have so much fun making a film, and I love just being like a little piece of it, and then finding out, I love Nat and Jim so much.
I know,
much.
You want it to say, just for them alone, it makes you so proud to be a part of it, and so happy for them that this is getting so much recognition, because they are truly funny, lovely men who I wish, you know, I could just be in there. Acting troupe forever.
I have a feeling they may write another movie at some point.
Better. I better.
Maybe
I hope they'll.
Oh my God.
So, do you ever want to see it with an audience? Will you see it again, or are you kind of done once?
I would like to. I'm going to go to the LA Film Festival that is showing it on the 23rd, and I think I'm going to see it then. I might see it with the audience. It's not good. I think I'm not alone, but a lot of actors don't like watching.
It's always interesting. The reactions are always interesting.
But we're not in it all the time, which makes it easier to watch.
Yes.
I don't know. I really enjoyed watching the film because I'm not in it that much. So I was able to enjoy you and Liam and Sam and everyone's performance because they were working when I wasn't there.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh, that's great. That scene turned out so well.
Are you
going to
be here for the 23rd?
I am.
Okay, good.
I think I'm going to watch because I like to hear people laugh.
All right,
and they laugh a lot in this movie.
All right, let's do
it. It's a real audience movie. So do you... Is a movie like this, do you feel it when something like this begins to happen? Obviously you had that night and you partied and you had a great time and you sold the movie and all of that, but I mean, when something goes this well, when there's kind of this positive energy that people have about the movie, do you get a sense of that in your lives, or are you kind of separate from the hoopla?
I wish that AnnaSophia had been in Sundance with us, because that's when I really felt the this great surge of support and energy and love for this movie that was, I couldn't have had a better time. But I haven't been around Jim, and I haven't been around everybody since then. So I'm starting to feel that again, doing this press junket here, and I'm certainly, when I attend the premieres in LA and New York, it'll be nice to feel that love again. But in between, I you know, out of sight, out of mind.
What do you get, like West Wing a lot, or do you get a lot of Drop Dead Gorgeous?
Oh, a lot of Drop Dead Gorgeous.
Oh my gosh,
which is very funny. That's the funniest, when people come up and or they reference some play I did in 1874.
So were you shy always? I mean, you seem like you're.
I'm very shy.
Telling us you're shy.
I'm not shy.
Oh, I'm very shy.
Well, maybe not on set.
I'm extremely shy. I'm extremely uncomfortable being. That's why I'm an actor, right? Because I would like to be somebody else.
So how old were you when you decided you wanted to act?
I don't think I ever decided I wanted to. It just sort of happened. I never, I purposely did not make the decision because I was afraid it wouldn't happen. So I would never admit that I was an actor. But I started doing it, in high school. My mother was an actress, so I just kind of did it in high school and college, and then someone filled out an application for me to go to the Neighborhood Playhouse. I didn't do it. My friend did it, and then she told me, you got in, you're going. I'm like, really? All right. Very strange way to lead your life.
So is there a point in which you said, okay, now I am an actor?
Yeah, when I won my first SAG Award. Totally, I got up. It was part of my speech. I said, now I can say I am an actor.
So you really
felt that
the moment you felt it.
I felt like it was officially like, wow, I've been I won something. It was kind of cool.
It was like almost better than getting a SAG card.
It was definitely.
So that's a big moment.
That's a big moment, too. I remember that. But getting that award, especially because it was given to you by your peers, by the actors, it felt kind of extraordinary. And that was one of my favorite.
Well, you were kind of in the actors category.
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
People feel like you're really part of the family, I think, for a lot of people.
I like that. That's it. That's totally fine with me. I like being in that position. That makes me happy.
And for you, AnnaSophia? Was there a time when you decided this is your future?
I'm sort of in the same boat with Allison. But before your SAG Award, I don't know, when people say, so what
do
you do?
Let's bring the SAG Award for AnnaSophia.
I feel weird, but I'm saying, like, I'm an actor. I'm like, oh my gosh, did I just say that?
Yeah, why is that so hard to say?
I don't know, because it sounds, there's like this idea that when people say, oh, I'm an actor, it's like, oh, you're struggling in Los Angeles and it's not going to happen. And so secretly, like, that's kind of when it comes out of your mouth. It's like, oh, because that might be me. And I just feel like I've been in school my whole life. So usually my answer has always been, well, I'm in high school, but I'm working, and now it's like, oh, wow, I'm not graduated.
You're working.
And I'm working.
You are an actor, and you are working.
Yeah.
You can absolutely say that with confidence.
Yeah, because I am working, so that's exciting. But I also want to do, other things. I feel like I need to do theater.
After we finished this film,
I was like, I want to do improv classes, and I want to do theater. And there are so many, it's like opened so many doors. So I guess when people ask me what I do, I think about all the things that I also want to be doing.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Well, the truth is, this movie really does everything. The actors, the adults, the grown-ups in the movie, really a group of people who've done kind of everything. It's not a limited, one-trick pony group at all.
No.
Yeah.
Tony's done, every possible kind of everything.
Yep.
And, Steve has done all kinds of stuff, so it's a good group to hang out with.
I know. Steve is really great.
Yeah.
Really wonderful.
So did you ever struggle with acting? Was it ever, like, a hard time getting a gig? Or did you never even think of it like
really
that?
I feel really blessed. No, I feel like I've had such just a wonderful path. I came out here when I was 9, and I did auditions, and my mom came, we were out here for pilot season, and then I got my first role, and then I got another one, and then it just kept going, and then in between I would go back to school, and then I sort of took a break in high school. I did one or two films, and then I graduated last year, and then I did this, and now I'm working, and I'm deferring from school, so I feel like I love working hard. That's what I realized. If I'm not working, I'm like, what do I do? Oh, God. Because I've never not had something to look forward to, or being like, what am I doing?
How come you have such a good work ethic and you're so young? Like, how did you get your...
It's because slave labor and my mom.
Your mom? Because that's good. It's impressive. No, she's very professional. And she, like, you've learned a lot for especially not having done theater. I think that's where a lot of people get very disciplined as actors in theater because of the... If you're late, you don't go on stage. Someone else goes on for you. Like, yeah. It's very disciplined.
And
I know. So that's how I learned. I'm always on time. I'm never... Never... late. If I'm late, it's I might as well kill myself.
But it sounds like you never really got, you're not into the Hollywood party scene or all of that. You kind of skipped that part of the activity.
Oh, well, you know, it would be fun to try it out.
Well, but she lives in New York.
But I live in New York.
And there's a New York party scene.
Yeah, but I'm working.
Yeah. All that.
Yeah.
Doesn't stop Lindsay Lohan. That's a whole other conversation.
She's not working right now. No.
She's not going to follow in her footsteps.
Yeah, I mean, it's everyone has their own different path. I think I, too, am cat-like, and I'm just lazy. Like, I literally am also
really?
On the couch, just kind of like,
I had no idea we were so similar.
Yeah, I like watching, going to plays. There's so many fun things to do in New York with the time that I don't have the energy to go out, you know? Mm-hmm. It takes a lot of effort.
Yeah.
It's a lot of work. You could buy tickets for plays online, and then you take the subway, and then you sit for a couple hours. You know? I can do that.
Just hide out in the Starbucks?
Yeah.
So did you know when you were shooting this, that can you feel when it's working and everything is beginning to come together, or is it always a guess with every project?
I don't know. What do you think?
I read the script, and I thought, This is just great. I don't care how it does. I just want to be a part of it. And my team was really excited about it also. And once we were on there, and I remember looking at it before. I mean, there wasn't really anyone attached to it way back when.
Mm-hmm.
And then I remember getting a call like, Allison Janney is doing this, Steve Carell, Tony Collette. And I went, oh, I'm not surprised, but this is so cool.
Yeah.
And after all the people involved were on it, I knew it was going to be great because it's a great script. It all starts with a script.
Mm.
And I met Nat and Jim, and I was like, I have total faith in them. They knew exactly what they wanted.
I tend to not get ahead of myself and think about how it's going to be received. I know that with the people they cast, that we were going to have a great time. We did have a great time, and then it's... And then it's out of my hands, and I hope it's as well received and as loved as I hope the experience that we had doing it translates and it's received the same way. But you never know. I've had things go the other way too. But
so is how a scene is playing as you're playing it part of that feeling of what the experience was? I mean, obviously, you all had relationships in this movie. You became friends and hung out together and all of that. So that sounds like it was a lot of fun anyway.
Yes.
But sometimes those movies end up being bad movies because everybody's so relaxed, they forget to make a movie.
Yeah. No, Jim and Nat were very... Oh, they were on it.
Yeah.
We were the ones that were able to have fun that weren't so it. I didn't have to worry about directing it or thinking about a shot list or...
I was barely in it, so...
We just had fun. They had to be responsible, and they were, and they did an amazing job, so...
And do you want a shot list?
Yeah, sometimes I do, just so I know how to gauge my performance.
No, I mean, do you want to direct?
Hell no.
What you really want to do is direct.
No. No. Let me be clear. No.
So don't call you with a directing credit.
Do not call me with a
directing credit. Star Wars 8.
I would hate everyone coming to me saying, what do you think about, how do you... I'm not good at making decisions or... No. Nope.
So having been an actor for a little while, you like being an actor?
I don't always like being an actor, but it's just what I do. It's what I do. What else
but you
could
don't
I
have
do?
This expand. You don't want to do other things.
I wish I did. It's kind of boring. Maybe I'll produce. I could produce, maybe.
I could produce. Yeah, I'd like to produce.
Yeah. I think that might be.
No.
I think we're going to start calling you Allison Janney Jr. I think we're going to maybe... It sounds like you've got a lot of the cat-like thing. You got
learned. I taught her some things.
I'm like a cat at night, I think. You know, when they're like super active, but they don't really go anywhere. That's me.
That's very funny.
I'm not the day cat.
Yeah. I'm the day cat, you're the night cat.
And has this gotten any more fun or easy over the years?
Doing these things?
Yeah.
With someone else, I hate doing them by myself.
I hate doing them by myself as well.
Yeah.
not comfortable doing these things, really.
I always feel like there's a right answer.
Me too. Yeah, I do too.
And they're like, oh.
I don't know what the movie's about. Don't ask me. What's I don't know. I just
what do you
do,
think it's about?
Yeah, I feel like people are looking for me to say the thing that's going to be their soundbite, their perfect, and it's never going to come out of my mouth, ever.
Do you like talking about your character? You like talking about how you find things and all
that? Yeah, I like talking about the character. I can do that. But talking about broader, you know, themes of what the movie is and how people are going to react, I don't know. Yeah. I hope the people like it.
And you don't like either. Like
it. I can talk about my experience doing it and how much fun I had or what it was like to work, la la la. But the whole experience of finding it, then I feel like I'm re-finding it. And then, did I make a mistake when I was doing it? Or is there something I should change, but I can't go back? I don't know. I can talk about the experience.
Do you like sitting over there? Do you like talking?
I do, because I find that it's funny. It's often people who I don't even think are going to be that interesting. Yeah. Everybody has a story. You know, everybody's chosen to be an actor or a director or a writer, people I talk to. And I find even sometimes when I don't expect anything, once somebody kind of relaxes and tells the truth, they're interesting people. They have, you know, they're passionate.
Yeah.
So that keeps me interested, because the rest of it is just BS.
I know. But I like that when you have things to. I'm sorry, I totally interrupted
you.
I was just going to say, when you have being an actor and you get to memorize a script and say, it's like, there's such freedom in that for me to have it on the page to know what I'm going to say. Even if there's some things that change up or a little improv stuff, but that is freedom. This is terrifying to me of not knowing. It doesn't. It's not as comfortable to me.
Because it's you. It's not your character anymore. Yeah.
And even better, 8 times a week when you've been going through it and really have it down after a few months.
But every time, that's why I love that theater. It's like it's like Groundhog Day. You know, if I do it right this time, I won't ever have to live this day again. You know, do this play again. It's kind of fun to give yourself that. So every time I do the play, I would be looking for something new or some way to do it better that would, as a game, you know. But I haven't done theater in a while now. But I do love it. It's where I started, and it's kind of great to have that immediate, all the energy in one room at one time.
So when opening day comes for this in a few weeks, will you notice? Will it be on will you be paying attention to box office on Saturday morning or any of that? Or is that just kind of somebody else's
game? No, I won't. Yeah. But I hope someone calls me and says, do you know?
Yeah, that's what I hope too. Yeah. What's the nice thing about film is that you do your part, and if everyone else does their part well too, then you have nothing to worry about. It's, you know, it's like such a team effort. Nothing is so, I mean, except for the directors, you know, that's kind of the big job, but once I've done my part, it's just like I'm excited to see what they do with it and where the film goes. And I never thought they'd be advertising this film as much as they are. I don't know, I guess it just seemed more of like a quiet summer movie, and it's turning into they're going over like to water parks. They've been in Denver, hometown. What? Yeah, it's exciting. I didn't expect that.
I didn't know I was going to be on the poster, frankly.
Yeah, neither did I.
Oh, really? Really?
Yeah.
I was like, oh my God.
Just wait for the Oscar campaign.
Oh my.
But I mean, this movie is kind of like now all of a sudden like the de facto summer comedy. This could be the biggest summer comedy as there any of them are. I mean, now that the internship has already gone away.
Sad.
It's like there's not a. This movie has just kind of got that summer thing, and it really, you're too young to have gone through that Porky's, Meatballs, whatever era. Yeah. But this movie really kind of fills that itch.
Gosh, I hope that is the case.
Yeah. I don't know. I never believed that until it.
Until there's a lunchbox in your picture.
Yeah, not in a bad way, but I just
What's
mean like...
What's going on back here? I didn't see we had a little set.
We just, this room was so incredibly ugly, we decided to try to dress it.
It's really cute.
We found anything we could in any closet in this hotel and stuck it out there. We
have shelves. I have one of those in my room.
You have one of those in your room? They do that. They're in the hotel. They put them in the closet because they were afraid we'd steal them.
I looked for candies in them. I thought they would have put jelly beans or something. I got excited, but no.
I think I have a Ben Affleck interview with one of those as well.
Hello. Oh, it's for you.
Oh, I can't talk right now. Thanks.
What? The Way Way Back box office records? How much did it make? $250 million in one weekend?
Did we break Batman?
Wait a sec. Can you say that again? You're breaking up. That would be a great phone call to get.
We're going to get you in Get Smart, too. You'd actually make a really good Maxwell Smart.
I would love that.
Really funny.
Well, why don't you direct it? Why don't you call some people? Why don't you do something and just sit on your ass over there talking to people, not having any, not putting yourself out? Come on, that's bullshit.
And I don't even have to get my hair done. It's perfect.
No.
Thank you guys very much.
You're welcome.